Well, that was from Northern Uganda. Now, the National Resources Committee of Parliament has met utility company Umeme during a fact-finding tour for selected installations. Discussions revolved around different issues like connections, status of Umeme's concession, and the quality of services offered by the company. Take a look.
Our success has become our problem as Umeme.
The legislators first visited Umeme's newly developed Nakawa substation and the control center at Lugogo before meeting at Protea Hotel in Kampala. Key among the issues discussed was electricity connections policy, status of the company's concession, and the constant outages in different parts of the country.
What is Umeme doing to reduce, to detect, first of all, detect and reduce the frequency of outages?
I also want to know who are the contractors that does supply you with the yaka meters, and why does it take too long to receive those yaka meters? Because in Western Uganda, Bunyoro sub-region where I come from, 3 years down the road, the issue of delayed power connectivity has been because of the yaka meters.
The company attributed the low and delayed connections to lack of funding for the electricity connections policy.
Currently, the funding that is available only covers no pole services. The funding gap as we speak is about 500 billion shillings for the current financial year. We have in the pipeline over 200,000 customers that are waiting to be connected, Ugandans. So the targets for the connections can be achieved. However, the challenge is funding.
Because of funding not being available has left us as utilities, whether it's UEDCL, Umeme, PACMEX, Wenereco, we are looking extremely bad in the eyes of the customers, that we are not responsive, there's excess power being produced, we don't want to connect them, and the funding is not available. It's leaving us. We even put in our money on ECP. Up to now, we have around 59 billion shillings. We incurred that money in 2019. Up to now, we have not been paid as a utility.
The issue of the company's 20-year concession that expires in 2025 was also addressed.
Yes, at the time we negotiated our concession, the terms were not as favorable for Uganda. And many of those terms are going to be revisited. You've got to pick them. I'm a Ugandan, I understand that. Giving us a guaranteed 20% return in dollars is not acceptable in today's time. Cost of money has come down, the factors prevailing have changed. So let's review it, but let's sit down and negotiate and discuss so that we can come up with a win-win. If one side wins, the other loses, it's not sustainable. And that's the beauty of this regulator we have. The regulator has always worked on our, whether it's a PPA or whatever contract, they want to do it so that they can shine in the end. But they do it by making us succeed. Now our success has become our problem as Umeme.
Umeme is expected to comprehensively write to the committee responding to the wide range of issues raised by the legislators. Story by Benno Jambo for the news.